Homeostasis is one of biology's biggest buzzwords. So what is it exactly, and why is it so important? Keep watching to find out. Briefly defined, homeostasis is the maintenance of a stable internal range within an organism. Range of what, you might ask? Your body has loads of variables that it monitors to make sure that everything stays in that Goldilocks zone of just right. For animals, this means that receptors detect deviations from the normal working range of those variables, and the body systems respond in various ways to try and return those variables to the normal range. Let's look at a few examples in the human body. Thermoregulation is the maintenance of consistent body temperature. For humans, that's approximately 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit, or 37 degrees Celsius. Receptors in the nervous system detect temperature changes in the internal environment and send signals to the thermoregulatory center in the brain's hypothalamus. The hypothalamus then directs the body's systems to respond, dilation of blood vessels and sweating if it's hot and the body needs to cool down, or constriction of blood vessels and shivering if it's cold and the body needs to warm up. Osmoregulation, or maintaining the balance of electrolytes and water in the body's fluids and across cell membranes, is another important homeostatic process in the human body. When things go too far out of balance, damage to cells can occur. For example, when blood pressure or solute levels are too low, cells in the hypothalamus detect changes in osmotic pressure in the blood and alter the secretion of a hormone called ADH, which acts on the kidneys, blood vessels, and sweat glands to reduce water loss. Another way the human body maintains homeostasis is the regulation of blood glucose levels. The body's cells need glucose to carry out cellular respiration, but the concentration of glucose in the blood shouldn't be too high or too low. Keeping the right level of glucose in the blood is the pancreas's specialty. After eating, much of your meal is broken down into glucose by the digestive system. This gets into your blood.
When beta cells in the pancreas detect this high blood glucose, they release the hormone insulin, which signals cells in the muscles and liver, as well as fat cells or adipocytes, to take up the extra glucose.
Once the glucose level is low enough, insulin release stops. However, as your body waits for its next meal, glucose levels can slip down below the normal range. When that happens, alpha cells in the pancreas secrete glucagon, which triggers the release of glucose by the liver and body cells. To learn more about how key physiological processes maintain homeostasis in the human body, check out the 3D models, animations, and more in VB Suite at visiblebody.com/VBSuite.